Welcome you all to our MITS 5001 week 4 online lecture. If you want to write the project scope statement, what we have to do? We have to write the important project document. And if you see that the details of the project scope statement are based upon the work you done or your project team and also the business analyst have already gone through down requirements gathering. So it will elaborate the requirements and define the exactness of project deliverables. For example, if you have to create a website that allows customer to log into a secure area of the website, so this requirement does the functional attributes of the deliverable, the intricate detail, and the behind the scene programming. Now, through project scope statement, you can actually define for that example that the web service software, the database type, and the security expectations of the web server. Okay. Now, project scope statement have some functions or some parts. For example, first one, product scope description. What does it do? It actually defines the product scope either directly or reference to the reader to a specific document. So it will create the product, service, or the condition defined in the product scope, and finally the requirement documentation. Now we'll see a description, a figure where you can see a project actually starts with project charter. We already know that. Then it goes through project scope statement to work breakdown structure. We'll discuss it today. Then through the project execution, it actually go to the project closer when you close the project. Now, if you see this heading of this figure, changes early in the project are easier and less costly than changes later in the project, which is very true and logical. So if you make changes here, it should be cost effective because you are not going to close the project. And if you have to change those things here, actually you have to do a lot of things before you can close the project. So it's better that, in summary, it's better that you fix your errors in the initial stage of the project. Now, after product scope statement, we need product acceptance criteria. What is that? It should be the condition that must be true for the project deliverables to be accepted and the project to be closed. So it should be the condition of project deliverable and project closure. Now the project deliverables is very easy. You can see the example. The customer may be expecting new software from project, but the creation of software will require your project team to buy certain resources, acquire hardware, and so on. So you will be creating all sort of project plan, templates, and reports that can use to other project. It means that not all project deliverables go to the project customer. So your project customer may have 2 or 3 or 5 project deliverables. But to achieve those deliverables, you have to create more deliverables. So that's why they're mentioned here. After that, we need project exclusions. We already discussed in previous classes that you have to establish the boundary of the project. As soon as you fixed your project boundaries, you actually eliminate the other things which is not in your boundary. So actually you eliminate many assumptions and disappointments when your project is near closure. So that's why when you fix your boundary, you actually exclude all the things which is not included in the project. Simple as that. Then we have the project constraint. We already know that we have some constraint. We have to work on this as well. It means that, say, of course, your budget, your schedule, and contractual term. So it are the constraint. You have to work through this. You cannot avoid or overlook those things. And finally, project assumption. We also discussed it previously. So for example, you can see, you might assume a vendor will be available for the duration of your project, or make some assumption about software compatibility and data security. However, if this assumption is not proved to be, say, successful, what happened? If your vendor is not available during the time, you actually can miss all the project schedule. Actually, so it's a devastating. So those things, assumption, it means you have risk, but it has to be assumed so that, and stated so that we can take the necessary actions and precautions. Now, project scope statement, it also may require that you create a constraint log and assumption log rather than listing them directly. So what happened? You need to update or create stakeholders directory and include all those things so that all the stakeholders are aware of those things. Thank you all for coming.
The Victorian Institute of Technology has other great videos covering many different topics. Please check them out, and thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe the video for more great content like this.